In the previous parts, that is the part 1 and part 2 of this video series regarding the brain anatomy, I have talked about the broad anatomical classification of human brain and described its superficial visible structures. This video, the part 3 of the series, is a continuation of description of superficial visible brain structures. This part deals with the base of the brain, which include the inferior surface of cerebral cortex, the brainstem, and the cranial nerves visible in this view. The parahippocampal or hippocampal gyrus is a gray matter cortical region of the brain that surrounds the hippocampus and is part of the limbic system. The region plays an important role in memory encoding and retrieval. Asymmetry of this gyrus between the cerebral hemispheres has been observed in schizophrenia. The occipito-temporal gyrus forms the inferior surface of the temporal and occipital lobes. It is involved in higher processing of visual information like color processing, face recognition, body recognition, word recognition. The olfactory nerve is the first cranial nerve which forms the olfactory tract and olfactory bulb, which lie in the olfactory sulcus. A sulcus in the medial orbital gyrus or straight gyrus on the inferior surface of each frontal lobe. The olfactory tract divides posteriorly into a medial and a lateral stria. Caudal to this is the olfactory trigon and the anterior perforated substance. Destruction to the olfactory tract results in ipsilateral anosmia, loss of the ability to smell. The optic nerve, also known as cranial nerve 2 or simply as CN2, is a paired cranial nerve that transmits visual information from the retina to the brain. It will be discussed in detail in the fourth part of this video series. Now, you see the pituitary gland or hyperphysis. It is an endocrine gland about the size of a pea, weighing 0.5 grams in humans. It is a protrusion of the bottom of the hypothalamus at the base of the brain. I will be discussing further about the pituitary gland in part 3 of this CNS series. The brainstem is the posterior stalk-like part of the brain that connects the cerebrum with the spinal cord. In the human brain, the brainstem is composed of the midbrain. The pons is separated from the midbrain by the superior pontine sulcus and from the medulla by the inferior pontine sulcus. It contains tracts that carry signals from the cerebrum to the medulla and to the cerebellum, and also tracts that carry sensory signals to the thalamus. The pons is connected to the cerebellum by the cerebellar peduncles. The pons has the respiratory pneumotaxic center and apneustic center that make up the pontine respiratory group in the respiratory center. Now, you see the different cranial nerve emerging from the pontine medulla junction. That is, the cranial nerve 6, abducens nerve, cranial nerve 7, facial nerve, and cranial nerve 8, vestibulocochlear nerve. In the medial part of the medulla is the anterior median fissure. Moving laterally, you see the medullary pyramids. The pyramids contain the fibers of the corticospinal motor tract also called the pyramidal tract. The ventrolateral sulci is lateral to the pyramids. Emerging from the ventrolateral sulci are the cranial nerve 12, hypoglossal nerve, rootlets. Lateral to these rootlets are the olives. The olives are swelling in the medulla containing underlying inferior olivary nuclei, that is containing various nuclei and efferent fibers. Lateral and dorsal to the olives are the rootlets for cranial nerve 9, glossopharyngeal nerve, cranial nerve 10, vagus nerve, and cranial nerve 11, accessory nerve. Cranial nerve 3, the oculomotor nerve, emerges ventrally from the midbrain, while the cranial nerve 4, the trochlear nerve, emerges out from the dorsal aspect of the midbrain. Between the two pyramids can be seen a decussation of fibers which marks the transition from the medulla to the spinal cord. The medulla is above the decussation and the spinal cord is below. The posterior part of the medulla is shown later in the third part of this video series. In my next video of this series, I will show the structures at the base of the brain. For the viewers who have watched only few parts of this video series, I would advise them to watch all five parts in sequential order to understand the anatomy correctly.